Today we're going to talk about the BLTouch on the MKS Gen L version 1.0. In a few moments, I'm going to talk to you about what we have for where we need to hook it up and what servo pins we need to use. So hang on. Okay, before we can connect the BLTouch, I need to talk about the NStop connectors and servos. So first we have our X-Min, our X-Max, our Y-Min, our Y-Max, our Z-Min, and our Z-Max. Inside there, down below on the silk screen, you can see that it's written voltage for this pin, ground for this pin, and then signal for this pin or this pin, and it's the same all the way across. The one that we're concerned with is using Z-Min. Now, here are our servo pins. There's three pins in a row, and there's four rows of them. The first pins are the numbered pins for signal. The next set of pins is the voltage pins, and the last set of pins is your ground. So we're concerned with D11 over here, and we're going to connect our BLTouch in just a moment. Okay, to connect the BLTouch, we want to have the brown side on the outside because that's our ground, and we're going to attach it right here. Next, we're going to attach the ground side to the center pin, and the signal pin is going to be right here. So in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware after I show you how to connect the USB. Okay, to connect the USB, we got to connect the big side to the USB port. And then we want to connect the smaller side to the computer, and you're going to hear a beep. Now keep in mind, you don't want to touch any of this area now that it's energized. This is about the only thing you can touch. So in a moment, I'll show you how to load the Marlin firmware. Okay, now that we're in the Marlin 1.1.9 folder, we're going to open that up. We're going to go to the Marlin subfolder. We're going to press M on the keyboard, scroll down to marlin.ino and press enter. Now we want to go to the configuration.h tab, do a search on motherboard, and as you can see, the motherboard is specified as board_ramps_14_EFB. That means that it's a similar architecture to the MKS Gen L version 1.0, so we can leave that alone. Next thing we want to do is do a search on touch. And as you can see, define BLTouch is commented out, so we're going to remove the comments. Then we're going to scroll down, and for this tutorial, we're going to remove the comment for the time delay. Next, we're going to search on number of servos. So we're going to do num servo. And right now it's set to number of servos of 3. But what we first want to do is uncomment it so we can use it. Then we're going to change 3 to 1. And as you can see, servo delay is set for only one servo in this case. If there were multiple servos, you'd hit comma 300, like for instance if it was 2 for num servos. But in this case we only have 1. So next we want to check to see if we're connected. So we have the architecture for the Mega 2560, which is the same chipset as the MKS Gen L. So we're good there. We're going to check to make sure we have a COM port selected, which we do. We have COM4. So all we have to do is compile and upload with the upload button. So So we're going to press this, and in a moment I'll show you in Pronterface how to test it. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder, so we're going to open up Pronterface.exe. We're going to connect to the 3D printer board. Now, in order to test this, first we need to know what the status of the end steps are, and we only have one connected, so it's M119, and then press enter. So X-min and Y-min are not connected, so they're showing as triggered, and Z-min is connected. So what we want to do is we want to home the Z-axis in Pronterface, and I'm going to actuate with my finger the BLTouch after I press this. So here we go. Okay, now that we're back in Pronterface, what we want to do is do the M119 again to check the status and press enter. And as you can see, it says triggered. So if you like my video, please press the like button and subscribe. And thank you for your time.